Hey preteens, welcome to another Wednesday night worship. We got a little game for you just to start off the night. It's called Identity Crisis. So you're gonna be shown a superhero and you're gonna have to guess the name of their secret identity. All right, so let's go ahead and start. Let's see who's first. All right, so we got Batman. All right, so you gotta guess what Batman's real name is or his secret identity. So I believe if I've studied enough for this game, I believe it's Bruce Wayne. Is that right? That's right, okay. All right, y'all gonna have to check me, but hopefully y'all got that right, and hopefully I just didn't, okay. Anyway, let's move on to the next one. Captain America. This is one of my favorites right here. So I guess, let me see, Steve Rogers. Okay, so Steve Rogers, if y'all got that right, let's move on to the next one. All right, Professor X. This one's a hard one. I don't know if anybody knows this one. You gotta be like real true fan for this one. So, let's see. I know his last name is Xavier. If y'all get the first name, I'll give you lots of bonus points. Let's see what his real name is. Charles Xavier. All right, so Professor X, Charles Xavier. All right, let's do one more. Wolverine, also known as Hugh Jackman, as Kay likes to note. But what is his secret identity in the movie? Now this is kind of tricky. He goes by two names in the movie. So is it James or is it Logan? All right, so if you guessed either one of those, you are correct. Thank y'all so much for playing the game with us. Now let's go into a time of worship led by me and Andrew.
Hey preteen, so right now it is time for you to stand up, find some space, and we're gonna sing a song called Great I Am. I encourage you to pick one of the Hebrew words of praise and choose to do that right now in this moment as we sing the song together.
Side, so heaven is real and death is a lie. I want to hear voices of angels above singing as one. Hallelujah, holy, holy God Almighty, great I am. God Almighty, great I am.
I am. Hey preteens, thank you so much for worshiping with us with Andrew and Eugene's song. Right now, take 15 seconds to grab your Bible, a pen, and a notebook, and turn to Psalm chapter 149. We're going to be looking at verses 1 through 6.
Hey preteens, so today we get to finish up our study on the seven Hebrew words of praise. And just as a reminder, praise is an outward expression of worship. So we want to be able to do that as Christians to bring honor and glory to God in our lives. So the last two we're going to be looking at today are Barak and Sabach. So we're going to be looking in Psalm 149 at verses 4, 5, and 6. So I hope you have your Bibles, or we're going to go ahead and read it right now together. So here's what it says, starting in verse 4 of Psalm 149. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people. He adorns the humble with salvation. Where you are right now, say the word humble. Let the faithful celebrate in triumphal glory. Let them shout for joy on their beds. So say the word shout. Good job. Verse 6, let the exaltation of God be in their mouths. So the first one I want us to look at is Barak. And here's what it means. To kneel down, to bless God as an act of adoration. So we've heard this word probably growing up, the word humility, or to be humble. And here's one of my favorite quotes that kind of explain what that looks like in our lives. So humility is not thinking less of yourself, but thinking of yourself less. Let me say that again. Humility is not thinking less of yourself, putting yourself down, but thinking of yourself less. So not always being consumed with thoughts about me, 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 I, right? So we want to think of others as more highly than ourselves is what it says in Philippians chapter 2. I encourage you guys to go read that chapter when it talks about true humility, because our humility is supposed to match that of Jesus Christ, who existing in the form of God, did not consider equality with God as something to be used for his own advantage. Instead, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even to death on a cross. That is the type of humility that we are supposed to mimic in our life. And so this Hebrew word of praise, Barak, is very important for us to kneel before the Lord in praise, to choose specific times in our lives to do this, whether it be every morning, every night, during a worship service, whatever it might be, to get on your knees before the Lord, because that helps our heart match the posture of our body, to be before the Lord, humbling ourselves, saying, God, you are more than me. So the second Hebrew word I want us to finish up with today is the word sabach. And here's what it means. Here's what it means. To shout, to address in a loud tone, to command, to triumph. I don't know if you've ever had something amazing happen in your life, but I have. And so a lot of times I'm like, woo, that's awesome. You're right. I scream, I get loud because you are excited. And that's something we want to do because we have been saved by this humble Savior that has come down and died on the cross that we deserved. And that's worth celebrating. That's worth shouting about every once in a while. So when it says in verse 5 of Psalm, let them shout for joy on their beds. Let them shout for joy. When's the last time in your life you've shouted for joy for the Lord, to give him praise in that way? So I encourage you guys this week to do that, to humble yourself before the Lord, Barak, to kneel, to praise him with a bent knee, but also to praise him with sabach, to praise him with a loud shout and triumph for all our King has done in our lives. Pray with me. Jesus, we thank you for the gift of salvation that is in you and you alone. Thank you, Father, for giving us a way to connect with you through the blood of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. So God, with that resurrection power, would you help us to be humble enough to bow before you, to give you our lives, to adorn you with praise, Lord, and then in humble celebration, God, to shout your name, to shout before you, God. You are worthy. You are worthy. So God, we give you our lives to proclaim your glory. We give you our lives to love you, to praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Preteens, thank you so much for joining us again for worship. Over the past 4 weeks, we've gone through 7 Hebrew words of praise. Over these next few weeks, months, and years, think about how you can implement these words of praise into your life.